I fought for the glory of Sauron.
Some of the orcs started climbing the rock walls. Our entire existence.
Thank you. Luia.
Thank you.
I don't know if the future is written or unwritten. My mind could travel up and down these paths, and they were like memories. But like memory, the mind would shape them to suit its ends. Were these my fears or my hopes? It takes a cold eye to see the future for what it is.
Gondor's artisans rival the elves in their dedication, if not their skill. None more so than our weavers. Paint on a wall of canvas will fade in time, but thread retains its vibrant color for centuries. The Numenoreans taught our people the art of the loom generations ago, and it is a talent we've nurtured ever since. Our tapestries immortalize our greatest triumphs. But it seems there's always another enemy to darken the horizon.
Survived. How did you find me?
Oh, it was easy. I just followed the trail of dead orcs.
The Nidral. Did she escape Minas Ithil?
We were ambushed. I lost her. Many of our brothers were captured. Some remain in hiding. Sauron's armies continue to hunt us.
Nidral is resourceful. But no one survives in Mordor for long.
We have a way out. I just need to find her, and whoever's left.
Then we must find them all.
Some of our soldiers were sighted in this encampment.
Tread lightly. We must be careful.
Out there, Ranger. We can't stop searching.
Come face!
one!
You'll never get away!
These orcs will suffer now.
I see the ranger! Here.
Cannot delay. When you find Idril, escape to the west. Have a second chance in life.
I've already lived two lives. I was born somewhere near Umbra. Herodrim.
That is a long way from Minas Ithil.
My order sent me to Gondor as a guarantee of peace. But the Herodrim had other enemies. I was to return, but by the time I was 10, we lost contact. I lived a good life in Minas Ithil. I was respected. I was happy. And then it fell.
So now you commence your third life.
The only life that matters is the one with Idril. But we have to find her first.
And that we will.
The Uruks use our soldiers as bait. Those are the lucky ones.
Have you managed to free many of your brothers?
Not enough. Some weeks we lose as many as we rescue.
Post for 2 days.
Stop searching. These orcs will suffer now.
It's a catacomb.
Hey! You've got quite the bath if you made it to me. Well, it ends here. This is the place you die.
Time to spill some Uruk blood.
I'm in your debt. Captain Baranor.
Karis. Are there any others?
Idril. She's alive. We were on our way to the fighting pits, and we were captured. She escaped. If I know Idril, that's where she's headed.
She's alive? She's alive. And dead hope.
We will find her.
This fortress holds many magic users.
Good thing I have you with me.
I've never seen a warg, but books and traveling hunters have told me plenty. The goblins of the north can ride wargs as the men of Rohan ride horses. Their howls can be heard leagues away, and their senses are keen enough to track even a ranger. What makes a warg truly fearsome is that they hunt in packs of a dozen or more. Caragors are more dangerous, but they travel in smaller numbers. A feeble blessing, that.
Right, don't break it! Come back!
Sport of our misery.
Then we will make misery of their sport.
Kill my beastie! I kill you!
I didn't make that move.
So much the better.
The end, my beast!
Die!
You're alive!
For now, let's deal with these orcs first.
It. I've searched everywhere for you.
And I you.
Come. I'll escort you to Haneth Anu. You'll be safe there.
No. I'm not leaving Mordor. Not till all of our brothers are free.
Come now. We will speak of this later.
My father sacrificed all of Minas Ithil for my safety. I will not be protected any longer. Not by you. Not by anyone.
Idril, you will die out here.
Then that is my fate. But I'm staying. Go. Go, reinforcements will be here soon. We will meet again.
She's a true warrior. She fears nothing anymore.
Yes, that's the problem.
would you wager on in a fight between a drake and a grouse? No, in the sky, the grouse standing on a cloud. Glob.
The lamps of Eregion illuminate a room with a soft glow, one that leaves only the most tenuous of shadows, a light that seems willing to turn corners and reach further than it ought. When we stored these lamps in the Great Hall, I would light them for an evening every midwinter just to ensure they still functioned. They cheered me so much that I always resolved to do so more often, but then I'd forget or put it off. How I miss their light now.
I think we're either short on food, or we have one Uruk too many.
Who else is ready to start? Hey? Anyone? Because I am!
have you!
Wait.
He despised the greed of men, the predictability of the dwarves. But most of all, he hated the elves, who wished to embalm the world. Middle-earth will change, he told me. It will bend to my will. It will not be fixed in place, and it will not be restored to the vision of its makers. It will become something new.
He wishes to remake the world in his own image.
His image will be wiped away from Middle-earth when all is done.
I need to find some more grog. It's the only thing that keeps me warm.
Lord! Show me your mettle!
Cyan. Tower.